Hey, this is Rob with Adventure IQ, and we've got a small project that we're going to do. Actually, a large project. We are going to repaint our YJ. Now, I've tried to do some Rattle-Can projects in the past, and they really haven't turned out too well. But you know what? The nice thing about this project is that the paint is already badly deteriorated. We've got some body damage that we need to fix, and this is really just the right time to go ahead and do it. We're taking a totally different approach than what we've done on other projects, in that we are going to fully prep the vehicle, which we haven't done in the past. The other thing is, instead of using multiple camouflage colors like we've done, we are going to go ahead and use just a single solid. Now, I haven't decided if I'm going to use the tan or olive drab. We'll figure that out in the next couple of days. But the first thing I've got to do is get in here, get the fenders pulled, get the body work done, and then we'll go from there. So getting the fenders pulled was really quite a bit of a chore, and it took both Melissa and I working on it to get it done. We had several of these screws that just simply wouldn't come out, and I eventually had to just take them off with the cutting wheel, and I've been in the process of hammering that back out and just making it flush. Now, for the first pass, I'm using 200 grit sandpaper. Once I get the primer thrown on, I'll use 400 grit sandpaper. But this gives me a chance to go ahead and fix some of the body damage that's been done to this Jeep. This Jeep was really not well taken care of body-wise before I got it, so we're fixing a lot of the flaws with that. For my first run, I'm going to test my painting ability with the door. So tomorrow morning, Melissa and I will get out here after I've got all this sanded down, and we're going to mask off the doors, and then I'll learn by trial and error of painting the doors first. So we're using a heat gun to pull all the logos off of the side of the Jeep, and we'll have to come back in. We'll get all the sanded down before painting it. With some of the areas where you've got a little bit of excess glue, don't sand those areas, but you want to use a product like Goof Off to help get rid of the stickiness prior to sanding. Otherwise, you're just sanding that glue right back down into your paint. So Melissa doesn't really want to be in this, but we got to show the work that she's at least doing. She's going through, and right now she's masking the doors, and as she's doing that, I'm starting on the other door, and what I'm using is Rust-Oleum primer. Because we're going to paint this in sand, I'm using a white, or actually a gray primer. And as we do this, we're just going in, we're spraying really, really light coats as we go through. Now, once this is done, we'll go in with some 600 grit sandpaper and sand this down. Depending on how rough the primer is going on, we may even use something like a 400 grit. But what we want to do is put several coats of primer on, and in between each coat of primer, we're going to go ahead and lightly sand that just to keep it roughed up. And I want to get a really good primer base on this. These vehicles put up with a lot of abuse, and you know, we're always scratching tree limbs and things like that. So one of the reasons I'm using the can paint is that when I do go out and we get some scratches and dings and things like that, when I get back to the house, I've got my instant repair kit. This might be kind of hard to see, but what we're trying to correct, one of the main things we're trying to correct, is where you see the oxidization of the paint up here on the hood versus where it used to be protected by some type of a vehicle bra or something like that up here on the front. So we're going through and we're sanding. The other thing we've got to be able to do is, if you remember from previous postings, you probably saw that I had lights mounted up here. So we're pulling these brackets off, and then today we are picking up a rack. Now, it's probably not the rack that we'll settle on, but it's one that does get us through the winter, gets us through ski season, gets us through the last bit of kayaking, and we're getting it at a really, really good price. We're getting hooked up with some folks off of Craigslist that, just want to help us out, so that's kind of nice. Anyway, we're getting it at a great deal. We'll probably put it on next weekend. We're going to spend the majority of our time focusing on priming and painting this weekend. So Melissa's back here using the heat gun to pull off the last little bit of the pinstriping, and I'm sanding and working on doors, and we're just working as a team to get all this done.
All right, we're slowly making progress, just a coat at a time. We have put about five coats of primer on the doors, and then we have just started to do our base coats, and then we've got two coats of primer on the Jeep itself, and really maybe about three. We did hit the front area just a little bit more because of the abuse that it takes, bugs and that kind of stuff. Lots of sanding in between. Now we start out with 200 grit sandpaper in the beginning to take it back down or to knock off the paint. And the paint job that this thing had was really, really horrible. There was a lot of rough edges and a lot of bubbling paint, things like that. What we've done now is we have sanded in between the coats of primer using 400 grit, and then with the doors, as we've been doing the base coats, we've been using 400 grit in between base coats as well as in between the primer coats, and now we're going to start using 600 grit on the doors. Now the doors, we have we're actually ahead of the game on for a couple of reasons. One, they were easy to pull off and start working on those while Melissa and Abby were working on with other parts of the Jeep. The other is, because I take the doors off and on so much, we know they're going to take a lot of abuse. So we wanted to really build up the coats of paint and primer, give it time to harden, and that would just give us more of a durable finish on those doors. When we get ready to finish out the entire Jeep, the doors will be hung back on the Jeep so we can just paint the entire Jeep together, and that way we've got good color blending and everything.
Probably one of the things that we should mention is that we're going to do the hood last. It is a very big area. I wanted to make all my mistakes on other parts of the vehicle before I progress to the hood. Also, the hood has probably got the most amount of work. It was probably in the worst amount of shape. And also, I've got my Adventure IQ logo up there that, quite honestly, I wasn't quite ready to get rid of just yet. Okay, so early on in the project, we pulled these fenders off of the Jeep, and they were in some really, really bad shape. New ones will actually run us about $500. And what I've decided to do is to come out, and where we've got all these flaws, I'm using 200 grit sandpaper, and I'm just sanding all these rough spots out. And then I'm going to paint them black. All right, so here we are. It's Saturday night. We decided we're going to shut it down for the evening, but we've got a lot of work that we've gotten accomplished today. And Trigger's ready for some daddy time. But hey, bud, here, let's move over just a little bit so people can see. But as you can tell, we have got the initial base coats on to the Jeep. At this point, we have two coats of primer, at least two coats of primer, probably a few more. We've had an opportunity to go in and sand with 400 grit sandpaper. Now as we start progressing through, we're going to move over to a 600 grit. It takes a little bit longer to sand out the rough edges, but we want to start getting that paint where, from the way I understand it, where it's getting a little bit smoother each time as we move through. But we're progressing. We've been at this for well over 24 hours at this point, and we've got about another 24 hours to go. The goal is to get everything finished by tomorrow evening so I can drive this rig to work. And I think we're going to get there. Feeling pretty confident about it. We'll throw the doors on tomorrow. That way, as we paint the rest of the vehicle, we're making sure that we're getting good blending between the doors and the rest of the vehicle. Then we'll start unmasking and be ready to show it off.
So I'm going to go hit the sack for a couple of hours, trigger with some daddy time, and that's where we're headed.
Okay, it's 7 o'clock in the morning. I'm going to let the rest of the crew sleep in. They worked really, really hard yesterday. Well, Abby played really hard yesterday. But Melissa is exhausted, and I'm going to let her rest a little bit. We decided we're going to go ahead and pull the hood and get it done as much as possible. That way it has a little more of a finished look to everything. So I'm going to start working on the hood, getting the stickers pulled, getting the bolts undone, and then I'll start sanding. I'm going to give the neighbors a chance to wake up. I don't want to hit them with a sander at 7:30 in the morning. The goal is to get done as quickly as possible today. And you think, why are we doing the hood? But we're going to have a lot of idle time while this paint is drying today. Melissa's going to come out this morning, hit it with the wet sander, or do some wet sanding on it. I've got to do the fenders as far as sanding and then getting them painted. Everything's taking a really long time to dry. We have low temperatures and high humidity right now. Now, the high today is only about 85, but that's not going to happen until 4 o'clock. And I would really like to have this thing well on its way to being finished by that time. So anyway, I need to get started. I need to fire up the heat gun. And need to start pulling some bolts on the hood. And once it gets down here, we'll go ahead and remove the hood off. And then I'll start sanding it. And I think I need some coffee.
Okay, so we're progressing along here. We've got quite a few coats on the Jeep. We went ahead and remove the hood so we can get it painted, and we're about ready to hang the doors. Melissa's over sanding the hood right now. She hates to be on video, so I won't show her. Right, hon?
Right.
And then this is the rack, and I'm going to start sanding the rack right now. All right, we just finished doing the wet sanding on the hood and laying out the real light tan. While we went down to go pick up more paint, because we were afraid that we were running out, and actually we were, we got down there and found out that they got the khaki in stock that really we wanted to do the vehicle with in the first place. So we're treating this as a base coat, and now, against some of my resistance, we're going to be adding on the khaki over the tan. So this is really the base coat, and this will be the color coat. Should be some pretty thick paint. I'm stressing. Melissa is pretty confident that we can get it done tonight, but I'm stressing. They only had 5 cans of this, so I'm hoping that the 5 cans stretches far enough. I mean, I'm thinking it's going to take 1 or 2 of these just to do the hood. But the wife has confidence, so we'll see. In the meantime, I've got a rack to go paint. So real quick check-in. I'm getting nervous because it's already 6:30. My plan was to start putting hardware back on around 6:30, or at least spraying our final coat. We have probably sprayed our second to last coat. We've got about 2 hours to dry. I've got all the lights on it, trying to pull humidity out of the room. We decided to go with a darker color at about 3:30 today, 3:30, 4 o'clock today, and we're going with a khaki versus the almond or tan that we were using. It really seemed like it was too light. We knew that we needed to lay down some base coats anyway, so that seems to have sufficed. What's nice about the paint we're using right now is it does stick really, really well. We do have a few blotches that are happening, but, you know, it's a trail vehicle. This is not a show car. This is not a mall crawler. This is not even a grocery getter. This is something we use specifically out on the trail. So nothing wrong with doing a Rattle-Can project on it. A lot of people scoff at doing rattle cans with cars. You know, if you do it right and you do a lot of really good prep work and you take your time, granted, we're probably rushing this one just a little bit, but the goal was to do one within a weekend. If you had 3 or 4 guys together that have done metal projects before, or painted metal and understand masking, you know, this project would probably clip along at a pretty good pace. I was really fortunate that I have Melissa, who is very, very good at masking projects. When I used to refinish drums, she did all my masking for me, and I trust her completely on doing the masking, because I know it's going to happen fast, and I know that it's going to be right.
I see what's going on with the screws.
Anyway, we just pulled it back out of the garage and she's looking pretty good. We pulled it out to the garage to pull off all of our tape, just because we still feel that might be a little bit of a haze inside the garage. Anyway, as you can see, it's starting to come along pretty well. We'll have to show more in the morning. All right, so thanks. Thanks to the help of Melissa and Abby, we painted a Jeep in 48 hours. And the only thing that we did not get done was the fenders. Had a lot of issues with the paint, with the fenders. We'd had those issues with it before. We've tried a lot of different things to try to get it to take paint. So that was the only hardware we did not get placed back on here, with the exception of the antenna mount for the CB. Some things that we could have done a little bit differently. I've got an old bikini top I wish I had placed over the Jeep to help keep spray from getting into the interior. Got a little bit of paint residue in there, or overspray. So I'll spend the next week sanding that out. Eventually we're going to rhino line the inside anyway. And I've got some interior work that I need to do at the back half for the Jeep to align it more with the expedition work that we're going to be doing. Sliding drawers and that kind of stuff. Other than that, everything else is pretty well done. We've got a couple of overspray areas. Not too concerned about that. We've got the mirrors mounted back up. I did take the time to some of the little hardware pieces that had to come off the Jeep, went ahead and repainted those. Make it look a little more presentable. But 48 hours. We are basically at our start time Friday night. And so it feels really good. That included sanding, priming, painting. It's a trail rig, so I don't know. To me, it looks pretty good. We'll get some shots of it tomorrow during the day. We're gonna let it cure overnight, and then we'll take it to work in the morning. I do want to get fender flares mounted up as quickly as possible, because of any road grime or anything like that coming up to affect the Jeep. There's a couple of sets out there on QuadraTech I'm looking at purchasing anyway. We'll just have to see where we wind up here in the next couple of weeks. So very excited. Again, 48 hours, and we have a freshly painted trail rig. Took care of some body issues. I don't know. The neighbors that have stopped by say it looks pretty good, and they can't believe that we got it done. The wife's really impressed with it, and I don't know. We're happy. Very, very tired, but happy. This is Rob with Adventure IQ. Thank you for following us along for the past 2 days as we took on this project. And we'll just continue to update you as we do other projects. Until then, we're out.